My goal is to try to make the train. I found
order of worship, a time that you see written out called the Marvel Promise. Very appropriate for us to take a look at the Marvel from this little jar. Represents another week. We've been doing these reminders since all school or a new season.
Through prayer, as we have our call to prayer, which will be hymn number 394, Something Beautiful. We invite you to sing along with us. takes all the pieces of life. Beauty of the resurrection. Father, the beauty of the laughter of children.
One is from 1 Samuel. Now the boy Samuel's visions were not widespread. So that he could not see what was going down. Here I am. Lie down again. So he went and lay down. The boy said, "Here I am, for you called for me." But he said, "I let him know that the Lord Now Samuel did not yet know the Lord called Samuel again a third time, and he got up and perceived that the Lord was calling the boy. Therefore,
and kind of older elementary kids, they get ready to go into middle school. A great opportunity for us as families to learn, to think, to figure out how we can help our children thrive. It's a real blessing. We're excited about this opportunity to really strengthen. Against hunger, we're going to prepare over 31,000 meals next week. When we get together for our packing event, great time. We need at least. We can go ahead, block out the calendar for next Saturday. Together, to be together. Sign up information out in the lobby.
Thank you. like to watch? Minnie Mouse, Dora the Explorer, any other ones? What do y'all watch now? Mary Alice? No, the Dukes of Hazzard. Hopefully in these shows you watch, they try to teach you lessons, right? I was little and it had a man. Jesus said, you have to love God, and then you have to love your neighbor. And this man who was a lawyer said, well, who is my neighbor? And so Jesus told the story about a man. And he was laying on the side of the road, and a priest, he had to get to the synagogue. And then a Levite, not, he had to get dirty and unclean so he could do the job. So you need to understand is and he took care of look different than us if they believe we still love them and they're our neighbors and that we still statement that we remember in our house if God does something and we don't understand it. Mr. Rogers talked. So when something happens, does anybody want to pray for us today? Okay, well, let's see.
Come. Is the gift of God, number 408. Our next reading this morning is going to come from the Gospel, from Luke's Gospel, Luke chapter 10. We're going to read verses 25 through 37. Luke 10. Body, heart, and spirit for the reading of our Gospel lesson. Lawyers stood up to test Jesus. To him, what is written in the law? What do you read there? Strength with all your mind and your neighbor. Jesus replied, a man was going and went away, leaving him half dead. The other side. So also a Levite while traveling came near him. And when he saw him, he was broken wine upon him. Then he put him in his own animal and brought him to his innkeeper and said, take care of him. I cast a few ways back. about Andrew Carnegie. One of the first things that it was talking about, well, is his name pronounced Carnegie or Carnegie? And there really is, some people say it this way, some people say different things that Carnegie did in his life. Just say it, guys. You burn the house down, you're going to need to call the bishop. Because I can take a clue. Just say, you burn down the house and you kill my cows, which I don't have, you know, like they not well received in ministry, which led him to the days of poverty. And Wesley said, if I that story, what they went through as children came. Okay. Good Samaritan. I mean, this is one of those go-to passages that you know all about. We all know the story, but you want to help the Jewish people. And you probably understand that were the children of these Gentiles and these Jews. And they and the Jewish people in Judah, southern part of the kingdom, did not get along. The Jews, kingdom, they in fact Jerusalem to really anywhere in Galilee. The Jewish people would go around Samaria. The disciples were like, whoa. Where the Samaritans are. We don't go where they are. That was the typical attitude. I kind of get that. You probably heard. All their stuff, so we kind of get that. Guess what? Samaritans are like, how many of us, white people, who make us? He saw the individual who had harmed him and his family. He saw someone who didn't even think he was fully human. Instead of glory, move with compassion. Towards his enemy. Showed him mercy. Mercy, there's that great line. Mercy is twice blessed. Changing people. And when we're asked for grace and mercy, it's his action moving forward. And now we get to see the Samaritan not just as somebody beneath him, as somebody who showed mercy. I'm drinking and cussing. Change the title. If you've been following our When you go God does for the people of Israel. Sacrificial system. Everything that happens in the nation of Israel will be different. They will be different. Everyone will say, Samuel, give us a king. That's not what you're made for. You're not made to be. Holiness is not simply not smoking, drinking, and have no evidence of the love of God in your heart. Samaritans, what did the Good Samaritan do? He took his oil and wine and poured it upon him. Of his money. Yeah, man, I love you, but he gave to him. To love the Lord our God with all of our hearts. With every ounce of our body. Our life in service of him. And likewise, to love our and service to our neighbor. Because here's what happens. God, and you live a life you find a purpose. You find a reason. Life of self-absorption. Life of self-consumption. Never. Will. All that you are. Feeling his grace should have brought in your heart. Live a self-outward love of each other. Jesus comes to say, I've come. Abundant life comes. It's not smoking, drinking, and cussing. That's legalism. You can do the right things. Love your neighbor, then what are you doing? Though I may speak with tongues, I love a God. This story was not told. Of those that we don't like, we say, we show compassion because we have been shown. We let his grace be made. This world needs Jesus. by God's love and God's grace, we can and we will change. Change us. May we live His love. God, help us to live out Your holiness. We ask it in Jesus' sweet and our time of communion. I invite you to turn with us to page 12. Table all the love who earnestly repent of their sin, to seek merciful God, we can invest the church. We have not done your will. We have broken. Toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, glory to God. Let us give thanks to the Lord. It's a joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty. Breath of life. When we turned away and our love failed, your covenant to be our sovereign God brought us to a land flowing and all the company of heaven. We praise your name and join their unending prayer. Heaven and earth. Suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery. By your mercy, we have been born anew. Now, living hope, undefiled and unfading. Once we were no people, out of darkness into his marvelous light. Well, the night when he gave himself for us, this is my body which is given to you. Do this in remembrance of me. As I said, drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant. I tell our flowing today, choir, balconies, and then the floor. So just kind of be aware of that. Might be a little bit different. And if the Spirit falls on you, you've got to run and take communion. Do this better than we have. my life and let it be Him free. Today's your first day to make that decision. Perhaps like to learn more about how to join our church. We'd love to talk.
Cross and light lead us out to our lives. May we be willing, as we have the opportunities, to show the love of Christ to those who believe in our hearts. And what we believe in our hearts, we live out in our Holy Spirit. Be with you all now and